So you want to win an NCAA championship. Some think it's easy, and on paper, maybe it is. Just win the next six games in a row, and you've reached your goal. But as Dickie B is going to tell you, these are the toughest six games to play. And you'll see that in today's game between the Akron Zips and the Maryland Terrapins.
This place is rocking and rolling, baby!
The Terrapins should be in for an easy one tonight, Dick. What do you see as the keys to their success?
The keys are very simple, my friend. First of all, be strong with the ball. Turnovers can be the story here tonight, so protect that basketball. Next, be monsters on the boards. Don't be afraid to get tangled up. Crash the glass. Third, don't be passive defensively. Be the initiator and force them to do things they don't want to do offensively.
Well, Dick, let's get this one started and see what happens.
Poor job offensively. I'm coaching. He's sitting next to me as an assistant coach. He's pounding the ball to the deck. Where's he going?
And up. And he knocked it home.
Big time three, man. That opens up the defense when you make that perimeter shot.
Good job defensively. They just won't give him any openings.
Pressure in the basketball.
Showing maturity by waiting for the O to regroup. Now trying to feed the low block. And he'll kick it back outside. Looks at the three. Way off target. Patience with the ball as the offense regroups.
This defender is resilient. Still applying pressure.
Dickie's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
10 on the shot clock.
Look at that spacing.
Number 33 handles the feed. He takes the shot off the baseline. Oh, yes. We get another look. He stays in control until they regroup the offense. Number 15 is feeling good.
Hey, Brad, I love players that play with emotion. That's why I love the college game.
He up fakes. He makes a nice shot fake. Goes up for two.
I tell you, once you get deep position like that, it's automatic.
Trying to feed the low block. There's a bad pass right to the defender. For the bucket, he hits the shot. Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going. Great steal. I think the pressure was just too much.
Tremendous pressure, just enough to force the steal.
The center receives the ball. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. And, Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot.
He's trying to see if there's an easy one out there. They are heating up this building with their shooting right now, Dick.
The hits just keep coming, baby.
Number 15 handles the pass. Here's a double team. Tries for two. Can't get the shot to drop. For two. And in and out. He keeps his dribble as they reset.
Nice high post screen.
Off the rim and no good. There's the block. There they come with a double team to stop it. He's typically a good shooter.
Yeah, but not tonight. He's got to accept that. Trying to go inside.
And they do. They got it on the low block. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
On the dribble, gives it up. Tries to get the D to bite. For the bucket, 10 on the shot clock. Down inside. And he'll kick it back outside. Gave it up.
There's the trap.
Number 21 receives the pass. He takes the three, makes the shot. ACC, one of my favorite conferences. Year in and year out, one of the most competitive conferences as well, Dick.
Hey, witnessing some good old ACC basketball here. These ACC teams are known for their up-tempo, fast-paced, and aggressive style of play. Very difficult to keep up with them.
Number 54, pump fakes. His shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely.
Problem with that, when you front, if you don't get some backside help, you're in trouble.
Well, you got to get help because you got to see ball, man. That's essential when you play on there and you front it.
Intercepted.
Pressure that basketball, help one another, communicate.
Fakes the shot. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. Up and in. Let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, guys, both teams seem to be playing very conservative. We're still waiting for one of these teams to throw the first punch, guys.
They work the perimeter. He tries to knock down the three. Way off target. Looking for a good shot. Unloads. Drains the shot. That one's blocked from behind.
Great rotation by the D. I love it.
Can't get the shot to go. Number 21 is charged with the foul. First team foul. He goes for three. Tickles a twine. The dribble, gives it up.
Double team now, bad angle.
He attempts the trifecta. He can't get the hoop to fall.
Dump it inside.
Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Work it around the perimeter. He fires it up. Off the rim and no good. They seem to rotate with perfect precision.
Hey, by all means, if a team's defensive effort is going to be successful, they must know how and when to rotate.
For two, they just can't find the open seams on the floor.
They're struggling to score right now.
Goes up for two. Perfectly executed.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards out there.
Yeah, that helps. Akron have put together somewhat of a run here.
Maintaining it is the key, though. They've got to continue to make the hustle plays at both ends of the court.
And a momentary look from three-point land in the paint. Puts it up, looking for contact. He's taking too many unnecessary shots, Nick.
And he's costing his team their rhythm.
He intercepts it. Full court pass.
Wow, did you see the mascot on the last dunk? He was going crazy. He loved it. I loved it. Those are the things that keep me coming back. Love that spirit.
They'll work it around the arc. For the bucket. In and out. Shot clock is dead. Tries for two. And off the mark. He missed on the steal. That's going to be the offense's game.
Yes, sir. They got the advantage right there once he misses that gamble.
And there's a lazy pass. It's stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way? Number 21 is whistled for the foul. Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
What a silly foul right there. But look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
Number 33 goes to the line for the first time. First one, good. And he doesn't miss that opportunity either. The ball goes out of play. He bombs from outside, way off target. At the end of the first half, the Zips lead by six. Just couldn't seem to stop turning the ball over in that first half, Dick.
Hey, if you ask me, these guys haven't clued on the magnitude of his game yet. They need to take care of the ball from here on in, or they have no shot, and they'll be running lots of laps tomorrow in practice.
Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment. Guys?
Thanks, Aaron. Dick, they're doing a great job defensively down there in the low block.
I tell you, what a great job on a defensive player. He's winning the battle on the interior because he's beating him to the spot.
Two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
On the inside. Fake. Makes the move and goes up strong, but that's an offensive foul there.
He's out of control, baby. Out of control.
And now they'll bring it up. They work it around the perimeter. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Gave it up. Looking for a good shot. Number 50 is pounded on his way up. Dick, how's that backcourt comparison shaping up, do you think?
Hey, Brad, that's a question that these coaches should be asking themselves. How can they, as coaches, get the most out of their guards? Are they quick enough to pressure the opponent, or offensively, can they create off the dribble? To me, it's about finding the weaknesses and attacking them.
Gets two at the charity stripe. Gives it up. shoots from left of the circle.
He can't get the J to go despite running off the nice screen.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing. Look at that spacing.
The point guard takes the feed. Trying to come up with a steal, and they do. And a momentary look from three-point land. They get that rejected.
Poor job on the offensive end. Great job defensively rotating to the basketball.
Gets it back out. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Strong rebound.
As soon as you get that defensive rebound, you should be looking to push the ball.
Here's the three ball. Not a whole lot of luck getting the baskets to fall lately, Dick.
They definitely aren't getting the bounces right now.
From left of the circle, Akron are on a nice little run at the moment.
Hey, they're going to keep pushing and seeing if they can't force a timeout.
Had him in the low block, but opted against it. There's a double team waiting there. Ball was tipped loose, but the offense retains possession. Number 35 with a huge jam. He shoots. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
He's getting it done out there, Brad. They'd be in trouble without him.
Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip.
A strip of a basketball. Got a little too fancy. Too much mustard there, baby.
Dumps it in. And now the fadeaway jumper. And he missed. Penetrates and kicks back. He shoots from left of the circle. Tickles the twine.
He missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
Gets the ball and now faces his man down in the low block.
Oh, very aggressive player once he got him in the face-up position in the post.
They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
The point guard gets the pass. Now the high screen. Around the perimeter. He launches the bomb. Poor decision. He has no business taking that shot.
Yeah, that's horrible, Mr. Nestler. Horrible shot selection.
Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
That's a great play. What a play. Demonstrating unbelievable skill. Now look at him. He's celebrating with the cheerleaders.
I love the zest in the young man. Dancing with the cheerleaders. That's awesome, Brad.
Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
In the post. Leaning in, trying to draw contact. Like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Boy, it's all elbows and shoulders down there, and I think the defense is winning, Dick.
I tell you, doing a great job in post defense. A lot of people don't realize that is an area that has to be taught, and this kid has responded in a positive way.
The shooting guard gets the ball. Went away from the post and goes the other way. With a deep shot from outside. He buries it.
Wow, let's check out the replay.
Looking for a good shot. Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, guys, down here on the sidelines, there is such intensity from both benches. Both coaches are emphasizing shot selection and defensive stops. So important here in the second half.
Good fake. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
Now the kick out.
Great elevator man, man. That's the elevator guy. What a high riser.
Intercepted. Cross court. Jumped in front to take it away. The small forward with the ball. Up. Easy one. This one might go down to the final buzzer.
At this point in the game, clock management and execution are really important. The team that does these things well will win, I guarantee it.
He throws it up from downtown. He gets the bucket. Gave it up. Takes the pass in the paint. Executes the baby hook. Can't get the shot to drop. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Sinks the shot. Picks off the lazy pass. Goes up for two. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. It's a five-point ball game.
That's not a lot of points to be down with this much time, Brad.
Working it around the perimeter. That's a nice fake. For two, no good from the field. Pushes it. They work the perimeter. The point guard takes the pass. For the deuce. Doesn't go. Timeout on the court, so let's go courtside. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Brad and Dick, with limited time remaining, the coaches will have to figure out their offensive and defensive strategies for the next few possessions. What they will discuss or fail to discuss during this timeout could be the difference, guys.
Aaron's right about that, Dick. We'll get back to the action here after the timeout. The lead is five. What happens now, Dick?
Well, this is where momentum can swing in your favor or go against you enough to blow your game.
He shoots from outside. Whoa, not a good decision to take that shot.
I don't think the coach wants him taking that shot.
On the dribble, gives it up. Gave it up. Goes out of bounds. And we get a look here at our foul and timeout situation.
Hey, Brad, many games are lost because coaches fail to manage the clock, possession, or air timeout situation. Let's see how these coaches fare tonight.
10 seconds to shoot. I gotta be sure they'll continue to look to foul here, Dick.
I'll tell you, it's time to start fouling in order to stop the clock.
That's probably why you're out of coaching. Too many points off turnovers.
I'll tell you one thing. That leads you to the exit sign. No question. You get to Ziggy. I'll tell you, you got to protect the basketball. You can't turn it over.
The Ziggy. I love that. Foul, man. That stops the clock again. And yet another foul.
Hey, now it's a matter of clock management, Brad. They have to foul in order to get back in this game.
And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. And they continue to foul to stop the clock. Hickey's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to land the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing them off.
Number one going to the charity stripe for the first time tonight. Rims off. See more focused play on both sides.
One would assume so.
5 points separate these two squads right now.
No one's leaving his building without a fight, Brad.
Picks off the pass. And the clock stopped with a foul. Number two going to the line for the first time tonight. Doesn't go.
Got to get one on this possession, baby.
With the shot. He couldn't get it to fall. And yet another foul. There's a turnover situation for the half, Dick.
I'll tell you, the lower the number, the better off your team will be. With too many turnovers, the likelihood of you playing in a game at the end drops significantly.
The second. 7 points right now is the difference in this one.
Hey, Brad, 7 points is no safe haven. You got to keep pressing.
He hits the shot. And they continue to foul to stop the clock. Dick, we all know how important it is to get to the free throw line.
Well, there's no doubt about it. I think it's such an unbelievable plus. It means you're playing aggressive basketball, you're playing attacking basketball, and you're creating all kinds of foul problems for the opponent.
No rebounding that.
They really need a score here to have a chance.
Think, Dick?
I wouldn't be surprised if they changed things up a little bit, Brad.
He goes for three.
The more possessions you create, the better your chances.
And the clock stopped with a foul. He goes to the line, shooting two. Up and in. Sinks it. They want to talk about it right here, Dick.
They got to find a way to chip into this lead before it's too late.
Maybe some game plan changes, Dick.
You never know what's coming, Brad.
He shoots from long range. The shot's off target. Dick, you've said it so many times, survive and advance. Well, one survived and will advance. The other one's gone home.
Well, I tell you, they won this game, Brad, when you look at it and analyze it, because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
The Zips open the tournament with an impressive first-round victory.
Winning that game was so important. A big first win not only keeps the team's championship hopes alive, but does wonders to calm these kids' nerves entering the second round.
So for Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.